Almost 10 years ago, Bill Rancic burst onto the scene as the first ever winner of The Apprentice, and it not only led to his successful business career, but it led to the chance for him to meet his now wife, E! News anchor, Giuliana Rancic, and today he joins me with his secrets for small business success, and he also has a very special giveaway, the opportunity for one lucky small business to win a free Super Bowl ad. Hi, Bill. How are you today?
I'm doing great. Thank you.
Well, thank you for coming on the program. And what were some of the biggest lessons that you were able to learn when you were starting your career in your small business?
Well, I learned a lot. I mean, I often joke that, you know, when I speak at business schools, that the way I started my first business is probably what every teacher will tell you not to do. But, you know, I learned from it. And I think for me, the mistakes and the failures that I had along the way helped me grow and helped me build confidence, believe it or not. And that was something that was important.
So what would you say were some of those mistakes that you don't really look at as a regret or a mistake, but more of a learning experience?
Well, I mean, I think a lot of times in small business, what holds most people back is fear. You know, it's the fear of failure, the fear of what your friends or your colleagues are going to say. You know, for me, when I first started my small business, I had to go in and I had to quit my job, and that was scary. And, you know, I always remember this Emerson quote. He said, always, always do what you're afraid to do, and success will find you. And I'm paraphrasing it. It's probably a little bit different than that. But, you know, that's something that I always remember and I try to embrace.
So when you look at small businesses today, do you find that a lot of them are following that quote and, I mean, they're really pushing and they have that passion, or do you find that some of them might just be looking to get by?
Well, you know, I think listen, at the end of the day, the American dream is still to be self-employed. It's to own your own business. And when you look at just the United States alone, we have 28 million small businesses, and they are all facing their fears because they're taking risk. They're risking their capital. They're risking their time. They're risking their reputation. So you have to embrace them. And I don't think we celebrate the small business owner enough because they are the largest sector out there employing people. Out of all the business sectors out there, it's the small business owner. It's the mom and pop guy who's hiring their first employee, or you know, the guy with 40 employees, you know, is trying to grow and build. That's so critical for our economy. It's so critical for communities, because when you have small business in your community, the money stays in that community, and that's how towns and cities grow and they develop. And it's important. It helps with education. It helps with, you know, the employment rate in those towns, and it just builds from there.
And it's usually those small businesses in the community that are very community-driven, that are involved in all of the events.
Oh, they sponsor the baseball teams, and they plant flowers on Main Street, and you know, they're the ones who are invested in those towns and those cities and those communities, and that's critical.
So what have you seen as some of the challenges that a lot of them are facing today? Since, I mean, we have seen this huge support with people when it comes to buying local and supporting that small business, but what are some of the bigger challenges that they're still facing?
Well, I mean, certainly it's access to capital. I mean, I think when you're a small business owner, you know, you don't have a track record, most likely. It's your, you know, probably your first venture, and I think access to capital is very challenging for many of them, and that's how they grow. So, you know, in order to be a small business owner, you have to be creative. You have to find ways to be your own publicist, to, you know, oftentimes go out and try to get investors, you know. And now with social media, it's really helping the small business owner tremendously, because there's ways they can get funding. There's different, you know, sites out there that are really great advocates to the small business owner.
So, I mean, you have noticed that in addition to where the community stands, there's just a lot of avenues to really help that small business succeed.
I think you have to, you know, you have to look at opportunity and not be afraid to seize opportunity. And I think, you know, when you look at a lot of these communities, they have chambers of commerce, they have the SBA helps people, you know, there's so many ways that you can get advice. But I think most importantly, as a small business owner, you can't be a know-it-all. You know, that's where a lot of these guys get into trouble. They let their egos get in the way, and you have to be able to, as I say, you have to be able to be the conductor. You know, when you look at the conductor of an orchestra, they've got all these experts playing their instruments. The conductor's not an expert at playing all those instruments, but he gets them to work together. And when you're a small business owner, you have to conduct. You've got to realize that there are other experts out there who can do things more efficiently, smarter, probably at a better cost than you can, and that's important.
And you brought up opportunity, and I hear that you have a very exciting opportunity for one lucky small business. So tell us about this.
Well, it's an opportunity of a lifetime, and I've partnered with the great folks over at Intuit. They make QuickBooks, and we are giving one small business owner the opportunity to get a fully paid, fully produced television commercial that's going to run during the biggest football game of the year.
And that's awesome. I mean, we know how many people watch the Super Bowl each year, how expensive those ads are. So for a small business to get that for free is exciting.
Yeah, and there's only 12 days left for people to register. They go to smallbusinessbiggame.com, and they have 600 characters or less to tell us about their business. And then America's going to vote, and we're going to narrow it down to the final four. I'm going to personally fly to each city and show up at the small business owner and let them know that they've made it to the final four. And then all of them are going to get a produced commercial. Only one will get one that's going to run during the big game. But all four are going to be big winners, in my opinion.
Well, that does sound like something that is a winner for more than one small business. Now, I also wanted to talk to you a little bit about your career, your reality show, and things like that. I mean, a couple
sure.
months ago, I got to talk to Giuliana, and she kind of mentioned that you were hogging Baby Duke a little bit. So how is that going?
I am a baby hog. There's no question about it. I'm fully not in denial. I love my little guy, and I take him with me everywhere. He's come to construction sites with me, and he comes to work with me, and he travels with us. So we're really loving being parents. And, you know, as you may know, we had a bit of a long road to bring him into this world, and now that he's here, we want to make sure we take advantage of every minute we have with him.
And I think that's awesome that you guys are so open to sharing, I mean, those moments with him through your reality show after everyone got to follow along and support you guys through that journey.
Well, you know, it was important for us, and ever since we started the reality show, and it's hard to believe we're in seven seasons now, but we always said we're going to use this show for good and not evil. And we used it as a platform to help others, and we've talked about, you know, our struggles with having a baby, and we addressed breast cancer, and we've really been able to use this platform wisely. You know, all my trips to Haiti we talk about to inspire others to go to these nations that are struggling. So we've done some good with it. You know, there's no doubt about it, and we're very proud of it.
That's awesome. And in addition to being a dad and being a small business owner with your restaurant in Chicago, I heard that you are also now the co-host of a show called America Now. So how's that going?
I am. I'm the co-host of America Now. I do it with a lovely woman named Lisa Gibbons. You may remember her from Entertainment Tonight and some of these other shows. She's been a real pro. And yesterday we had our national debut, and it's great. It's a news magazine show. It's news you can use. So again, it's a show that's helping people. We're giving people tips on their finances, on health, on how to repair your car, you know, and not get ripped off. So it's another show that I'm proud of, because it's actually giving people solutions to their problems every day. And I love that.
And that's awesome that it's not just reporting the news, but it's also helping people out, like you said.
Well, so many of these shows talk about the problems, and they don't give solutions. You know, we talk about the problems, but we give you solutions to those problems, and it's solutions that you can utilize immediately.
That's awesome. There's a show out there like that can really help people who are facing those tough times rather than just reporting on those tough times.
That's right. Well, hopefully people will check their local listings. I don't have it in front of me, but I know we are on in Philly, and people can go to the AmericaNowNews.com site if they're interested in watching.
Awesome. Well, where can people go to stay updated with you? And also, what's the website for the opportunity for the Super Bowl ad one more time?
It's smallbusinessbiggame.com. And they have 12 more days to enter, and then have them encourage their friends and family and people in the community to go vote for them. As they say in Chicago, vote early and vote often. And we definitely, I tell you what, I'm going to be showing up in these four cities, so I hope I'm coming to Philly, because I want to get some cheesesteak and hoagies.
Well, we hope so, too, and best of luck, and hopefully there's many more wonderful moments with Baby Duke to come as well.
Yeah, indeed, indeed. Well, thank you. I appreciate you having me on.
Thank you for coming on.
Okay. Have a good day.
You too. That was Bill Rancic. He's the original winner of The Apprentice. He's also a reality star with his wife, Giuliana Rancic, and he's an author and now the co-host of a new show called America Now, which his co-host will be on my show this coming Saturday.